Hi there, I'm Neil Griffin and welcome to my improvisation masterclass. Now, can I say straight away that this is the first part of what's going to be an evolving series going on for some time on guitar improvisation. It's going to cover all the best stuff that I know, and it's probably best if you sign up for this as a course. Can I say straight away, it's free, there's going to be no marketing or anything like that. But if you click the box in the top right hand corner of the video, now I'd suggest just stop watching this for a sec. Sign up for the free course, and then every few days you'll get a new video, so it'll be structured so it gives you time to assimilate this. And also other material that's not practical to put on YouTube, like sort of tab and other bits and pieces, resources that I think of. So I think it's best if you do that. That's your choice. But then you'll get this as a proper course. And as I say, I just want you to be able to sample my best material. My kind of work is working one-to-one with players online. And my hope is if you see this, you'll appreciate the quality of it, and maybe you'll decide that you want to work with me personally, and that would be great, but that would be your choice. So I just want to spend a few minutes now setting the scene for this. Please watch this, because I think it's important. It'll give you the context, and it'll explain to you kind of the problems I had when I was learning the guitar. I mean, I've been learning now since 1965. It's a long time. But it's not been an easy road, and really my job is to try and make this an easy road for anyone who wants to progress on the guitar. And I think the reason that it's hard to learn, and unless you're an intuitively great person like Jimi Hendrix or Wes Montgomery or someone like that, Eric Clapton, most of us learn by emulation. And in my case, actually buying a lot of guitar tuition material. The problem I found is the material isn't particularly well written. It's well meaning, but it's written by musicians, and they tend to only see what they see within a fairly narrow context. Whereas for the likes of you and I, we need the context. We need a system to be able to learn. And I mean, just thinking back, you're probably the same. I remember listening to Eric Clapton and sussing out the blues pentatonic scale. I mean, no one taught it to me. It's simple enough to work out for yourself. And I discovered that you could play that against loads of material, as I'm sure you did. And then there's the next breakthrough. I'm sure you had it the same, where you discover the major pentatonic and you discover it's the same. So I don't know, if you listen to something like Crossroads by Clapton, you can hear him using both on there. Then you think, well, I've sussed it now. I've got the minor scale and the major. That's all I need to know. But I come about 1974, I wanted to progress beyond rock and blues. And much as I love it, I wanted to get into other things, to be able to improvise differently, properly. And I tried to play funk. I tried to play jazz. It just didn't sound right. It sounded awful. And I really banged my head for years. I was stuck for years. You're probably the same. And I guess if you're watching this, maybe you're the same now. You've maybe tried a few other things, learnt licks or whatever, but it doesn't help you to progress. And I certainly was in that boat. And then come around about 1980, my then wife bought me a couple of books on how to play jazz guitar for Christmas. And I won't name the writer because it would be an insult to his memory. He's dead now. But the books consisted of hundreds and hundreds of arpeggios. And, you know, me being me, I always start something with good intentions. But if I can't see where it's going, I'll give up fairly quickly. And I must have gone around that circuit about a dozen times with these books. Until something happened. I was one day listening to Tal Farlow, who's one of my guitar heroes. And I suddenly realised he was playing arpeggios, just the stuff I'd been learning in these books, which didn't seem to make sense. And suddenly it all made sense. And by then I was sort of keen into other players as well, people like Don Mock, who were getting into arpeggios and their use. I guess Frank Gambale, though his stuff seemed less, some more out of context really. But anyway, suddenly the flash came, And I was able then fairly quickly to assimilate and play jazz. And what I've been able to do is systematize this approach. Since 2010, I've been teaching this to a number of players online. And actually, the results I've got of all my players have got has exceeded my expectations. I didn't believe that people could take this on so quickly. Within 5 or 6 months, I had people who just played pentatonic blues, playing sort of fairly complex jazz pieces. Now, it's not to say they wanted to play jazz all their lives, but the point is, if you take these techniques, you can use them in any style of playing. So, what the masterclass is about is introducing this to you. And I'm going to do that and probably go way beyond that and, intersperse it with maybe unpacking some blues solos and stuff and say, well, look, this is what's going on here, but you could play it differently. You could use these concepts. I remember we worked with something like Red House, the Hendrix number, and said, well, yeah, we could do this here or this here. Just introducing ideas. And I'm a strong believer that don't give someone something unless they need it. So there's way too much theory in a lot of books, or I don't know, unfortunately, with stuff on YouTube, not enough theory. You need the theoretical context, but only that. So I'll give you just enough of that. And I'll build it up step by step, which is why it's important that you watch these videos in a series step by step. And by the time you've finished it, you'll be playing like a pro. And it's important to me that you do because I need to demonstrate to you this material works. So I think that's a bit of background. Let me just stress again, if you sign up, and I think you need to for this, again, so that you can connect with me as well. I can give you other materials. I tend to do a daily email to people on my list so that just to talk about what's going on. Sometimes it could be related to gear or whatever, but get on the list. No marketing. Certainly, if you get on my list, I won't be sharing it with anyone else. Do that. The next lesson, we're going to get into this. We're going to start this journey and really get into it. So I reckon if you're going to crack this, you need to devote about an hour a day to it on average. If you're up for learning to play the guitar well, to play it properly. So over to you. I'm going to stop now and hey, I look forward to hearing from you. Cheers for now. Bye.